So with GW's standard mission format moving closer to an ITC or Nova style that includes secondary objectives, I've been seeing a lot of posts from folks who are new to the mechanic and wondering what the best practices are when it comes to picking those secondaries. So I figured now would be a good time to go over playing with secondary objectives in mind and how you format your lists around them. What's up, folks? Welcome back to Tactical Tortoise. My name is Trevi, and today we're talking about secondary objectives. Before we begin, a quick PSA that our coverage of the T5S2 Invitational is live now. We're online every day over the next 2 weeks with analysis and commentated live streams from some of the greatest players in Virtual 40K. So subscribe to the channel to get stream notifications and visit tts40k.com/invitational to see live results and our live match schedule. Alrighty, so with that out of the way, let's talk about some secondaries. In this video, I'm going to go over my top picks for each variety of secondary objective, including mission-specific objectives, and some tips for building your lists to take advantage of those secondaries. Today, I'm going to be focusing on the secondary objectives from the Grand Tournament 2020 packet, but since they're so similar to the ones in Eternal War, most of my advice for that format will be the same. So first off, a quick recap of what secondary objectives are. Simply put, they're special submissions that you can pick three of before each game of Eternal War or GT40K, and that you can tailor to suit your list or to counter your opponents. There are five categories of each secondary objective, as well as a mission-specific secondary for each mission in the packet, and only one objective from each category can be chosen for a game. So to start with, what strategies should you be considering when you pick objectives for each game? As a general rule, you should be prioritizing objectives that score you points for doing what you are already going to be doing during the game, like fighting your opponent's frontline units or holding your own backline objectives. Ideally, you should be looking to pick objectives that you can easily score at least 10 to 12 points from. I mean, really, really ideally, you should be looking to get the max 15 points from each secondary you pick, but sometimes that can be very difficult to do. The first thing to consider is the composition of your opponent's army and whether any of the objectives focus on killing it, namely the ones in the No Mercy, No Respite, and Purge the Enemy categories would be easily scorable from it. While controlling the board is how you score primary objective points, you will still have to engage with your opponent's army, so any points you can grab while doing so is also important. That said, you still need to consider the strengths of your own army as well, and how well you can actually take out those enemy pieces. For example, does your opponent have an abundance of any unit type that you can easily score Purge the Enemy off of, and how easy will it be for you to bring down those particular units? For example, if your opponent has 5 or 6 vehicles, bring it down may look like a good option, but if they're all artillery that will be hiding behind obscuring terrain, you may be falling into a trap while you're picking it. Likewise, your opponent could have a bunch of characters eligible for assassinate, but if you have no snipers or fast melee that can reach out and take them down, you may end up scoring less than you hoped on that secondary objective. It's important to consider how aggressive those units will be during the game. If your opponent's characters are melee focused and likely to get stuck in, you'll have an easier time taking them out to score those assassinate points, and if their vehicles are all dedicated transports meant to protect their objective grabbers, you'll likely have to kill them anyway in order to score. Now also don't forget about that No Mercy, No Respite category as well. Both thin their ranks and grind them down can be good options depending on your opponent's list. Thin their ranks obviously is good against massive hordes of single wound enemies, and grind them down is an excellent pick if your opponent has a high volume of small units or characters. And don't forget that the No Mercy and Purge objectives stack with one another, allowing you to score points simultaneously if your opponent's list is a good candidate for objectives in both categories. Now realistically, the only objectives from this category I would generally try to avoid are While We Stand, We Fight, unless you specifically desire your army around it, and Cut Off the Head. For Cut Off the Head specifically, your opponent's Warlord is typically one of their most difficult models to pin down, and you'll only score a few points if you don't take them out round 1 or 2, so unless they're a Titan or a big unit that you can easily focus all your fire on early, you won't usually score many points from Cut Off the Head. Likewise, unless your most expensive models are extremely hard to kill, or aren't prime targets for your opponent that they won't be trying to take out in the first place, While We Stand, We Fight often just rewards your opponent for proper target selection. If your three most expensive models are big tanks that are going to be shooting at your opponent, they're going to have to deal with them at some point during the game anyway, so picking them as targets for While We Stand, We Fight just further incentivizes your opponent to attack them. On the flip side, if you have a large support model that's difficult to kill and that isn't doing much damage to your opponent, they may be a good target for While We Stand, We Fight, because your opponent is less incentivized to attack them in the first place. Once you've selected any objectives that you can reasonably score by fighting your opponent, it's time to consider objectives focused around board control, namely the Battlefield Supremacy and Shadow Operations categories. Now, it's important at this stage to take into account the mission being played. If it's a mission with five objectives, like Priority Target, Sweep and Clear, or the Scouring, that makes Domination a fairly easy pick as long as you have fast enough units to run onto objectives by the end of your turn. This is because, with an odd number of objectives on the table, you'll only need to control three of them at the end of your turn to score. Typically, the two on your side of the table, which should be fairly simple, as well as the center objective, which you'll probably need to be fighting over anyway to remain relevant on the primary objective. Likewise, missions with six objectives, in which three of them are set up near your deployment zone, like Retrieval Mission or Overrun, are perfect for Raise the Banners High, since you can usually set up three banners easily on your first turn that are relatively easy to defend from your opponent. Outside of this example, I would typically avoid almost all secondaries that require your units to perform actions, including most of the Warpcraft secondaries. Especially avoid the actions that take an entire round to complete, completing either at the start of your turn, those being the ones that either begin at the start of your movement phase or at the end of your command phase, or are completed at the end of your command phase. This is because it gives your opponent the chance to deny your secondary points pretty easily with a couple well-placed attacks, taking out the units performing those actions. Engage on all Fronts and Linebreaker are both solid selections for armies that are fast and aggressive, but keep in mind that they both require the units scoring them to be wholly within the designated area of the board, which makes small, compact units like light vehicles, characters, or minimum-sized squads the best for scoring them. Large horde units may find some trouble confirming these objectives, but it's certainly still possible for armies with large units to push up enough to secure them. One thing to keep in mind as well, when selecting these board control objectives, is the first player advantage. They are typically much easier to score for the first player, who has the first opportunity to advance up the table and can easily counterattack any of the second player's units moving up to score them. If you are playing with the T5S2 house rules, under which secondaries can be selected after the attacker and defender are determined, I'd prize these very highly going first, while I'd consider Purge and No Mercy secondaries more seriously as the defending player. The last objective category is Warpcraft, and it's certainly the oddest one. Like I mentioned previously, I'd advise against almost all the secondaries that require actions to be performed, and this includes psychic actions, unless you have an absolute smorgasbord of psychic characters that you're just happy throwing away. Having to make a psychic test that could possibly be denied with enemy psychers or stratagems, on top of sacrificing all of your psychic output from that character in that phase, is a big risk. Especially for objectives like Mental Interrogation or Pierce the Veil that require you to jump through extra hoops and complete them several times to max the objective. Psychic Ritual is the only Warcraft objective I would consider for an army with psychers, and even then, only in matchups where your opponent doesn't have a lot of psychic defense that could easily shut down the ritual. Keep in mind that you have to complete the action three times in order to score any points from the secondary whatsoever, and you can only attempt it once each turn, so a single deny from your opponent can make confirming that objective exponentially harder. If your faction or army doesn't specifically need any psychic support, I'd strongly recommend considering leaving your psychers at home and opening up Abhor the Witch as a possible selection. This makes Psychic Ritual a little simpler from your opponent, but gives you an easy pick into any psychic-heavy matchups like Tyranids, Grey Knights, Chaos, and even some varieties of Eldari. You can even include sub-factions like Graia or World Eaters, or specific units like Kalexi's Assassins, to retain some level of psychic defense to compensate and make those psychic rituals harder for your opponent. Lastly, let's cover some of the mission-specific secondaries I'd consider most highly when you're playing that particular mission. We'll go down them just about in the order they appear in the book. First up is Minimize Losses from Retrieval Mission. This is definitely an army-specific pick. If your army is already defensive-oriented, it's a solid selection, and you can often score 10 points from the objective fairly easily, but if you're set up to be more aggressive and focused on small units, I'd avoid it. The Raise secondary objective from the Scorched Earth mission is absurdly hard. I'd avoid that one at all costs. Data Intercept is a solid pick from Vital Intelligence, provided that you have some decent terrain and can protect the unit performing the data intercept that's on your home objective. Since you can hold on to objectives that you control in this mission even if your units have left them, you can safely score 2 or 3 points each turn from this objective without effort. Keep in mind that unlike most actions which require infantry, almost any unit can complete this one. So if you have a tough vehicle or transport that you don't mind sitting out the game, they can be put on intercept duty pretty easily. I typically avoid the surround and destroy secondary mission, surround them. It's pretty much the definition of a win more condition. If you're already able to control objectives in your opponent's deployment zone for a full round, you probably don't need these extra points to win. And the same goes for overruns, aptly named overrun secondary. Similarly, for vital ground from the battle lines mission, this one's going to be inconsistent since your opponent will pretty easily be able to contest the center objectives, and nabbing their home objective will be almost impossible, making this one a little bit tough. And like most of the secondaries that require full round actions, I'd also avoid strategic scan from the scouring mission. Now, unlike many of the other mission-specific objectives on this list, direct assault from the sweep and clear mission is extremely easy to score, especially since you're already encouraged to fight over that center objective to score domination as well. Netting 6 points just for running some OBSEC models into the center objective is an absolute bargain. And the same goes for priority targets, the secondary from the priority target mission. Getting 3 points for doing something that you should already be doing, which is holding an objective in your own table half, is a pretty good deal. So those are some general tips for picking secondaries, but how do you really dominate the secondary game in competitive play? The key is to build your list from the outset with secondary objectives in mind, not only scoring them yourself, but also denying easy options for your opponent. If your faction is able to create effective builds that are compact, it's a good idea to cut some of your chaff so your list doesn't give up easy kills for grind them down or thin their ranks. Likewise, limiting yourself to 3 monsters or vehicles and limiting the number of characters in your list to make bring it down or assassinate more difficult is almost always a wise choice. Of course, this is much easier for smaller, more elite armies, and this style of faction tends to already be more effective at outscoring their opponent on secondary objectives. This does, however, come at the expense of sometimes being inflexible at scoring the primary objectives, however. Likewise, it's often a good idea to include 1 or 2 units you can sneak into the back of the table to ensure you always have the option to score engage on all fronts or line breaker, even as the defending player. 1 or 2 small deep strike capable units like Ripper Swarms, Tempestus Scions, or Tactical Drones are great for this purpose, since your opponent usually can't afford to screen them out too heavily while dealing with the bulk of your remaining force deployed on the table. So that's it, those are my picks for picking secondary objectives in these new 9th Ed 40k missions. By the way of a quick summary, as a general rule, I tend to avoid objectives that require actions and prioritize objectives that reward me for doing what I was already going to be doing during the game. You'll find that these are the easiest to score decent points on without compromising your game plan and losing ground on the primary mission. In addition, knowledge of your list and which secondaries it is good at scoring is important as well. And as you practice with a list, you'll quickly find the objective that fit it best. Once you begin iterating on a build, also try putting units specifically included to complete certain secondaries, like engage on all fronts. Pretty soon you'll get a good grip on secondary selection and you'll find that you're scoring even more points in each game of 40k you play. So, thanks for watching. That's going to be all for today, folks. As always, big thanks to my Patreon supporters who are totally awesome and get all sorts of cool benefits like early access to videos and exclusive videos. You can join them over at patreon.com/tacticaltortoise. Thanks again for watching, everyone. Remember to keep it classy, folks, and have happy wargaming.